I have two of these lanterns. They take three D-cell batteries. Pretty handy if the power goes off if I'm out here in the shop at night. I keep one out here and one in the house. And I have the calendar on my computer set up to remind me to check batteries every 3 months. That's not often enough. I checked the batteries in this 3 months ago and it was just fine. My calendar told me to go check again, so I was out here and I pulled the base off of this. It's just normal to turn it upside down when you're doing that so the batteries don't fall out. And when I unscrewed this, liquid ran out of here. It was like pouring water. It had completely filled this compartment, and it was soaking different parts of this. And of course, when I turned it upside down, that allowed that alkaline solution to get up here and get underneath these plates and possibly go into these holes that are here and get into where the electronics were for this. So I took this apart. There's a circuit board in here, and this is how I took that apart. You just need to note that it's red, white, black on the circuit board. I'm just going to unsolder this, maybe. Probably shouldn't have pried this apart first. And that wire goes under there, feeds down through the center. Now I'm going to unsolder this tab. Okay, so now that's unsoldered. Now the circuit board will come out. This aluminum piece is a heat sink for the three LEDs, and it's epoxied to this aluminum plate, which is an additional heat sink. And that thing is pushed down on this piece of plastic. Most of this stuff is not intended to be taken apart, so you have to just go about it gently. And I took a screwdriver and gently started prying this apart until it cooperated and separated. You can kind of see some of the stuff that was leaking out of that battery. These leaked like a sieve. There's no corrosion visible on these at all. And 3 months ago, these had no sign that they were leaking. That has to be the most fluid I've ever seen come out of flashlight batteries, and certainly in the shortest period of time. And I really can't tell if one or more was leaking. The major battery manufacturers usually state that if their battery leaks and damages your device, to pack up your device and the leaking batteries, send it back to them, and at their option they will repair or replace the device. I'm not sure the post office would be very happy about sending these through the mail. I think the moral of this story is quit buying flashlight batteries. I've just about converted all parts of my house over to Surefire flashlights. The batteries are good for 10 years, they don't leak, and when I pick up a flashlight, it works. The batteries in this that leaked had a December 2018 date on them. They should still be good. It's in an environmentally controlled building. It doesn't get real hot. It doesn't get real cold in here. I've had a batch of batteries dated 2024 that were leaking. They're more trouble than they're worth. They gotta go. I am not going to leave batteries in anything anymore. I'm gonna put some of them in a plastic box in the vicinity of where I have flashlights, and we'll take it from there. Now we have all the pieces that are required to reassemble one of these lanterns. This and this have been soaked in vinegar, and all of these pieces have been washed in soap and water. This was inspected to ensure there was no indication of any of the battery leakage had gotten down into these pieces. This is clean. It never got to that. So from that standpoint, we're pretty lucky. Now this is a rotating device, and this was full of the alkaline solution that leaked out of the batteries. It got underneath all of these plates, so soaking this in white vinegar and allowing it to sit for a while, make sure that it had time for that vinegar to get underneath there and neutralize any of that stuff that was in there. And when that was done, rinse it out with water, washed it with soap and water, and I put that in a warm room, allowed it to dry. On this piece, your metal contact plates down here, it's exactly the same problem. That alkaline solution could get underneath that. So I let this whole thing soak in vinegar for a while, neutralize that. This little plate here, I took a screwdriver and lifted that up so I was able to clean underneath that, because all of this had been soaking in that alkaline leakage. When you're done, push that back down. When we get ready to reassemble this, this has to go all the way in here and bottom out against the plastic before this is reattached by soldering. This switch has to be in the center of this hole, and this row of LEDs is the indicator light here to tell you what the setting on the light is. There's an O-ring that goes around here. You wanted to take that out and clean out that groove, because there was alkaline solution that had gotten down in behind that. The switch pops out of here easy enough, and it's actually made up of three pieces. There's two pieces of plastic and that's silicone. Took those apart and washed them with soap and water, washed the O-ring with soap and water, and let everything dry. There's only one way for the base to go on here. There's a hole here and a bit of a protrusion that's on this side. Those engage, and then this can screw together. And this is very loose, and what holds that together so it doesn't fall apart easily is that O-ring. When you put it in there, it makes a bit of an O-ring seal. And then up here on the top, there's an O-ring on this piece here. The insinuation is that you could carry this out in the rain, and it would be somewhat water resistant. And that slides on there like that. Really, that O-ring is what keeps that from easily falling apart. The protrusion that was on here that used to engage with these threads or grooves, it was pressed together at the factory. I was having difficulty getting that to go back together, so I ground the protrusion off so this thing will just slide on there. There is only one way for this to go together. This will drop in there like that. And with this piece on top of it and the three screws inserted, it can't go anywhere. The circuit board needs to be pushed in here until it bottoms out on these plastic shoulders here. And then I got to get this soldered back in place. And kind of run out of hands when you're doing this. Get a glob of solder in there. And that should take care of that. Yep. That's all the way down. That's soldered in there. Now we just need to reattach the other three wires. Part of the problem here is the bifocals. Put some batteries in here, check it before we go any further. These are Energizer. They're dated 2012, 5 years out of date. On the battery checker, they still test fine. Batteries are like concrete. With concrete, you have concrete that hasn't cracked and concrete that's going to crack. Batteries, you have batteries that haven't leaked and batteries that are going to leak. It's just a matter of time. I need to get that to line up on there. And we push this button. The LEDs come on. Push it again. It goes off. Push it again and again. It's half brightness. Push it three times in a row. And it goes down to a very dim setting. That's working as it should. Put this button back in here. And looking at my other unit, I verified that this is supposed to be pointing upward. The O-ring is back on here. Shove this in there. Before I put the screws in there, make sure that button is activating the switch. And one thing I almost forgot to clean were these little screws. They had been soaked with some of the alkaline solution. turn it backwards till it clicks, time the threads, put it back in the plastic. Have it back together. You can see this thing will flash every once in a while to tell you that the batteries are still good. Don't believe that, because this was flashing when I dumped the junk out of the bottom of this day before yesterday. Anyway, bright, medium, and low. Forget about leaving batteries in there. Take an old peanut butter jar, put them in there. Most peanut butter jars, you can probably get two sets of batteries in there, certainly the larger jars, and keep that somewhere near the light. If one of these batteries leak, it will contaminate all the other batteries that are in there. You may want to put the batteries individually into a Ziploc sandwich bag. However, I have had leaking batteries eat its way through two layers of a Ziploc sandwich bag. When this stuff leaks, it's pretty nasty. I have the calendar on my computer set up to remind me to check batteries every 3 months, and that's not often enough for things like remote controls. You consider how important this is to running your TV. So about once a month, go in here, pull the battery out, look at it, make sure there's no indication of wetness, no corrosion. Look at the contact points. A leaking battery can rot that spring out in a couple of days to a week. If it gets on the circuit board, it can ruin the circuit board very quickly. So check those at least once a month. And just because this device is still working the TV, that's no indication that those batteries aren't leaking. I've had flashlights that were operating at full brightness that had leaking batteries in them.